Hey there, it's Seb Frey here with another exciting episode of Seb Frey TV. Okay, today's episode I want to dedicate to the question of how much money should you offer for that home you are interested in buying? So to answer that question, I think the first place to start is by looking at current market statistics and seeing what is the average sales to list price ratio. Now in my market, it's very often that the sales to list price ratio exceeds 100%. It can very often be 101%, 101.5%, 102%. That is to say that on average, sellers are receiving 1 or 2% more than they're asking for their property. Now, in an environment like that, let's just say you want to offer 95% of asking price. Do you think that it is likely that a seller who is like looking at the other sellers and seeing that they're getting more than asking price, do you think that seller is going to accept much less than asking price on their property? The answer to that is probably a big no. And in my market, frequently, you'll see that sellers are getting 98.5%, 99% of asking price. Now, that's an important distinction, is asking price. Now, what you'll see is that many times sellers receive far less than initial listing price, but then they go ahead and they make a price reduction. Now, after a seller does like a significant price reduction, do you think it is likely that that seller is going to take a big whole chunk of money less than their brand new gigantic price reduction? The answer is no, because a seller is going to be knowing that, hey, sellers are receiving on average 99%, 100%, 101% of current list price for their homes. So the likelihood of a seller in my market anyway accepting a gigantic chunk of change less than full asking price, whatever that asking price happens to be, is very, very slim. Periodically, I do a little exercise and I go back and I analyze and I say, hey, how often is it that a seller accepts 90% or less of full asking price, or 95% or less of full asking price? And it is exceedingly rare in my market for a seller to accept less than 10% of full asking price. And I would say, how rare is that? It's like 2/3 of 1% of the time that happens. And how often do they accept less than 95% of full asking price? That happens probably in about 3 or 4% of cases, right? So it's pretty unusual for a seller to accept that much less than asking price in my market. Now, there's a lesson there not only for buyers, but there's also a lesson there for sellers. And that is that, let's just say you have a home that you feel is worth $900,000, right? And so you think, okay, well, I'm gonna ask for, say, $950,000, and that will leave room to negotiate. Well, the thing is that many buyers, the astute buyers, the ones who are actually out there making offers, they happen to know that in most cases, a seller is not going to accept a big decrease in the sale price off of listing price. They just know that because they're experienced. They've been out there, they've been in the market, they've been seeing what's happening, and they realize that it just doesn't happen very much. And so if they see a property which is overpriced, guess what they're gonna do? Are they gonna send in a lowball offer, even if that offer might actually be what the property is worth? Or are they going to not write a lowball offer? The answer is in most cases, they're not going to write a lowball offer because they feel that it's probably not going to get too far because they just see how the market is operating. So if you're a seller, again, I say this to sellers all the time, there is very, very little advantage to you to overpricing your property and leaving room for negotiation. In most cases, you're going to be much better served just by pricing the property right at market value. Because if it's right at market value, the market will recognize that value and they will pay that value, because believe it or not, there is a market price for your home. Unfortunately, we don't know exactly what it is, but we have a pretty good idea and we can get pretty darn close to a price where we know the market's gonna pay something very close to that number. So that is my advice for home buyers and for home sellers as well. All right, listen, do me a favor. Could you please share this with anybody who you know is thinking about writing up maybe a lowball offer on a house, or maybe somebody is thinking about listing their home for more than it's likely to sell for? You'd be doing them both a big favor. And also, do me a favor, give me a like, thumbs up, give me a heart, a click, a comment, and you know, for the biggest bang, share this with somebody that you know who is thinking about buying or selling real estate. I would really appreciate it. All right, that is it for this episode of Seb Frey TV. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll have a new episode up for you before too long.